The AKG P120 is honestly my favorite out of all of these microphones because it just has a great sound. It has a great roundness to it, great detail, little warmthness that I like, and also the controls on the front. And keep in mind, guys, I don't talk about any gear that I haven't used before. I may not have it in my studio sometimes, but I have used it. That's one of the core values of my channel. That's integrity. I wanna, you know, give you guys valid and valuable information by talking about things that I've actually used, not some hypothetical. Hey, I will cover news and excitement on some new products that's coming out, but I won't recommend it to you guys, you know, until I actually test it out. Will you give it to me? Oh, that body, baby. Now, this microphone is only $89, which is insane. As you can see, the diaphragm is small, but it packs that vocal punch, that clarity. It still delivers those mids. It doesn't have too much low end in it, but it sounds great. You don't have a big room. You don't need any big footprints in your studio. This microphone definitely is ideal for that. Just whatever you do, don't let this small diaphragm fool you. So, are you on a budget for a vocal condenser microphone in your home studio? You don't want to spend too much. You don't want to break the bank. Well, I got some good news. All of these microphones are around $100. What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to my home studio. I am Archie Beats and I am here to help. Today, we are giving you guys my top 5 microphones for around $100. Let's get to it. So I've been singing a really, 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 really long time since I was a baby, since I could remember, from church all the way to touring with my gospel group. And one of the first things I did when I turned 18, I wanted to start recording my own songs. I didn't want to go to a studio. I wanted to figure this out myself. And one of the first microphones I used was the AT2020. In fact, this microphone that I'm singing on now, it's only $100 as well. But before we get started, if you guys are interested in anything that you've seen in my home studio, be sure to check the description below. I have everything listed down there, including these microphones and also other gear that I've used on my creative journey. And hopefully that it can help you on your creative journey. So each section is going to be broken up into 3 parts. We're going to discuss the microphone, and while we're discussing each one of those microphones, we're going to actually speak through that microphone. Then we're going to discuss what it comes with, and then we're going to do an audio test after we discuss each one of the microphones. Basically, we want you boys and girls to hear how the microphones sound in the middle of a studio with no reflection filter around it. Let's not waste any time. Let's start with the AKG P120. The AKG P120 is honestly my favorite out of all of these microphones because it just has a great sound. Has a great roundness to it, great detail, little warmthness that I like, and also the controls on the front. And with it being a condenser microphone and an XLR, you have to use your Phantom Power on your audio interface or your preamp. Since using this microphone, the application for it is vocals, of course, because that's why we're doing this video, but you can use it on acoustic instruments. You can pair them up and use them for room mics, overhead mics, stereo pair, and it sounds just great. Brass instruments, string instruments. Hey, it's an amazing sounding microphone, especially for $99. The polar pattern is cardioid. That's the hard shape. Picks up mostly at the front, a little bit on the side, virtually none at the back. The diaphragm is about 0.68, is a 0.68 inch. It's not quite an inch, but it's still a large diaphragm microphone. The frequency response is 20 hertz all the way up to 20K. The max SPL, as you can see, the pad that's on board this microphone is 130, but it's 150 with the pad. The pad is negative 20 dBs. It gives you that extra 20 decibels when it comes to the sensitivity and the pickup with this microphone. The microphone is about 6.5 inches tall and about 2 inches across, and it's about a pound. And it comes with the microphone stand adapter that you screw this into the bottom of your microphone and you connect it to your microphone stand. That's pretty cool.
Baby, you to die for. Yeah.
Let's give a thumbs up to the AKG P120. On to the next. So this one right here was a surprise shocker when they released this microphone and Blue contacted me to just have me check it out. Didn't get paid for it or anything. And I decided to do a video on it. And I was like, whoa. This is a great microphone, and I like to test stuff out for like 2 weeks before I even mention it, minimum 2 weeks. Sometimes I go a month. I tested the microphone, and I was like, man, this is a great sounding budget microphone. Now, this microphone is only $89, which is insane. As you can see, the diaphragm is small, but it packs that vocal punch, that clarity. It still delivers those mids. It's not too much, doesn't have too much low end in it, but it sounds great. There are no switches on it. There are no, there's no pad. It's a straight microphone. Just hit the Phantom Power XLR, plug it in, and just go to town. Just whatever you do, don't let this small diaphragm fool you. Now, this microphone, it has a very voiceover podcaster and still singer-songwriter like application feel to it. You could use it for instruments as well. You could use it for string instruments, saxophone barrels, trumpet barrels, stereo pad room microphones. The small diaphragm still is able to pick up. And say, for instance, if you don't have much space in your studio, this microphone definitely suits you. You don't have a big room. You don't need any big footprints in your studio. This microphone definitely is ideal for that. The polar pattern is cardioid. That means it picks up at the front, a little bit on the side, virtually none at the back. The frequency response is 38 hertz all the way up to 20K. Now, most of the time when we're doing vocals, I roll off to about 200 or 300 hertz. This microphone still picks up enough. The max SPL is actually a little higher than the AKG P120. It's 132 decibels. This microphone can intake some volume. It's lighter, although it looks taller than the AKG P20 and any other microphones. It's 0.84 pounds. It's not even a pound. Now, this microphone comes with the actual, you can see the microphone stand and the microphone itself. This microphone, like I said, is definitely ideal for vocals.
Will you give it to me? Oh, that body, baby.
Now, I went on a microphone purchasing run like last year, and I said, hey, let me purchase a few microphones, a few $100 microphones. And this was one of the microphones that I purchased, and I tested this microphone for 2 weeks. You guys know my testing, and I was so excited to let everybody know about it, you know. And then, you know, shortly after that, I started working with SE, which is very awesome. They make very awesome microphones, but I purchased this microphone myself. And it just sound fantastic. You guys hear this. This is the SE-X1A. It's a large diaphragm condenser microphone, and it uses XLR. You're going to have to plug the XLR cable in and then initiate Phantom Power on your audio interface or your preamp. And one of the new things that they did with the updated version of this is they updated the capsule of this microphone. And it's really high quality to be $89. And also, when you think about it, you get two switches on the front. You get a high pass filter, also a pad on the front of this microphone, which is incredible. Of course, this microphone type is condenser, requires Phantom Power. The frequency response is 20 hertz all the way up to 20K. The polar pattern is cardioid. That means it picks up mostly at the front, a little bit on the side, and virtually none at the back. The low cut filter is 100 hertz. And the pad, as we discussed, is negative 20 dB. And just like the AKG P120, it's 130 max SPL, but with that extra pad on there, that negative 20 decibel, it can intake up to 150 decibels. And like we mentioned, the connector is XLR, so you're going to have to purchase an XLR cable. Now, what comes with this microphone is the microphone itself and the actual mic stand with all the clips and threads and accessories for that mic clip.
When you give it to me, oh, that body, baby. I feel so free.
It sounds great. You guys hear this microphone. The Audio-Technica AT2020. Of course, you guys see, this was one of my first microphones, and it still sounds great. And we had to get it in somehow. And this microphone was on the market. It was inexpensive. And that's why I always keep one in my mic locker. And I've had this one for a couple of years. This is a new updated one that I purchased two, three years ago. And it definitely gets the job done. It helped me in the beginning of my creative journey. And as you guys can see, it has a little more lower end. It's very detailed in the lower end. It's a little bit missing out of the middle, just a little bit. But it's not enough to be like, hey, you know what? We can't go with this microphone. This is definitely a great starter microphone, and you can use it professionally. This is considered a medium diaphragm microphone. When I first started out, I thought it was a large diaphragm microphone because it's the size of the average large diaphragm microphone. But if you look inside of there, you will see that there is a subtle difference. It's a little smaller inside of this microphone here as far as the diaphragm. So, of course, the microphone type is condenser. You have to use an XLR cable to plug into this microphone. It's not USB, and you have to activate phantom power on your audio interface or your preamp. The frequency response is 20 hertz to 20K. More than enough information. That's exactly what we need, especially when we're cutting those vocals, anything below 200 hertz and down. The polar pattern is cardioid. It picks up mostly at the front, a little bit on the side, virtually none at the back. The max SPL is 144 decibels. It could take a beating, y'all. It could take an input beating. It's about 0.776 pounds. It's a little under a pound. And what comes with this microphone is the actual microphone itself, the microphone stand mount, and also a pouch where you can pop your microphone in when you're not using it and just keep that microphone protected over the years. So you guys tell me what you think about these microphones.
Will you give it to me? Oh, that body, baby.
This sounds really different, doesn't it? Well, you guys are looking at the first of its kind. This microphone is the Aston Element. And do you hear that warmth? It has the warmth of a ribbon microphone, and it has that roughness, that intake roughness of a dynamic microphone, and it's a condenser microphone. And this is the Aston Element. And that technology that you guys hear, it has moving coil technology. It has a Ritian capsule. It has an active moving coil, and it's completely affordable. I just felt like, hey, I have to tell you guys about this microphone specifically because it's not necessarily 100 bucks, but what it comes with, as you guys can see, this magnetic pop filter on this microphone here and the actual shock mount for $149. And sometimes the microphone is completely $100 for the whole pack. But I just couldn't let this pass and not tell you guys about it, because you purchase any one of these other microphones and you buy a shock mount or a pop filter, you're probably going to be paying more than what you're paying now. So the microphone itself is around 100 bucks, but it comes with all of this stuff together. You can't purchase it separately. So I hope that does make sense. But I wanted to just let you guys know and put this microphone in the roundup, because we don't get this technology at this price. That warmthness you guys hear is that analog nice sound. So what you guys are looking at, this microphone is the result of 2,000 musicians voting. They reached out to musicians and said, what do you guys want? Let's vote. Let's build a microphone together and let's go. So this microphone has a unique active moving coil inside of it, and it's a distinct condenser microphone, dynamic and ribbon capsule design. All of that, all those type of microphones, dynamic, condenser and ribbon, all in one microphone. I'm really excited about this mic, and that's why I want to tell you guys about it. And it has an extended bass and fast transient response for a full and detailed sound. You don't get this normally in that price range. I keep saying that, but I really need you guys to get that part. You just don't. So the polar pattern is cardioid. Picks up mostly at the front, a little bit on the side, virtually none at the back. The frequency response is 20 hertz all the way up to 20K, but you guys hear that warmthness in there. We have some bumps there. The max SPL is 132 decibels. That's enough. And this microphone does require phantom power to operate it. So you have to plug in your XLR, and then you have to hit the phantom power on your audio interface or preamp. It comes with the shock mount. It comes with the actual pop filter. And if the pop filter is magnetic, as we discussed, an actual microphone itself, you will have to buy a cable.
When you give it to me, oh, that body, baby, I feel so free.
There it is. Sounds great. If you guys have any questions about any of these microphones, please be sure to comment them below. I will be happy to help you guys out and answer any of your questions. Don't forget to check them out below in the description. I have them all listed. Thank you guys for always supporting my channel. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Archie Beats. I will be dropping some awesome videos and quick microphone tips. You guys are absolutely fantastic. Don't forget to be great and create. This is your boy Archie Beats, and I'm signing off.
Archie Beat on the beat. Yeah.